This is the Pebble Psychomotor Vigilance Task, or PVT. It's a unprepared serial response task, or a simple response time task, where you just make a response to a stimulus. In this case, it's a red circle. And it tells you how long it took, and then sometime later, another stimulus will appear. You have to make a response. So the PVT, as it's called, originated at least earliest in the 80s. There was a device by Wilkinson and Houghton who developed a lot of different testing devices around that time for applied assessment of cognition, portable reaction time with data storage. I think it was like a modified tape recorder. But Dingus usually gets credit and is the most widely cited researcher in this area, and he did come up with a microcomputer version of a simple response time task. And so one or both of these often gets cited whenever a PVT is done. The interesting thing about the PVT is, unlike most response time tasks where you're trying to understand the speed of processing, this is especially designed to detect sleepiness if you're tired. And there's a couple different things it measures. So first of all, it measures your response time. There's no decision. You just have to push the bar or the space bar when the stimulus comes up. But if you're too slow, it counts this as a sleep lapse. And by default, a sleep lapse is any response time greater than 500 milliseconds. And it also records sleep attacks, so its response times by default greater than 30 seconds. And so this is a little different than most continuous performance tasks where you're assuming the person's wide awake, but these are usually given after sleep deprivation, so after you've stayed up all night or two nights, or maybe are influenced by medication or something, so that you can actually be staring at the screen for 30 seconds after the stimulus comes up and not be able to respond. So even if your eyes are open, you might not respond in that long, and it's this, and that's called a sleep attack. You've essentially fallen asleep while doing the task. So if you're studying sleepiness or sleep deprivation, the PVT or some version of the PVT is one of the de facto tasks that people will be doing. The Pebble PVT has been used quite extensively and dating back probably at least 5 years. Here's a bunch of papers that have used it in one way or another. Google Scholar shows 70 hits or so for Pebble PVT. I don't think all of these are really Pebble PVTs, but there's probably close to 50 papers that have used this. And so here we'll describe a little more about what it's for and how to use it. So if you want to use the Pebble PVT, you download and install Pebble, and it's when you first start up Pebble, it'll look like this, and the PVT is down here. Now, if you're running just the PVT, you might create a new experiment chain that will save these configurations, and we can append to the chain. So, and then we'll save this. And now, whenever we run this chain, no matter where we navigate here, the PVT will run, and it just makes it a little easier. And so let's start this up first and see what happens. So very simple instructions. If you want to edit these instructions, that you can edit them to make them clearer, or but simple instructions because it's a pretty simple task, and the instructions are also on the screen once you begin. So the only thing you have to do is be able to hit the space bar. So here I hit the space bar, and respond to the red circle, not to the cross. So that would have been a sleep lapse because my response time was slow. I'm just not attending. Here we go. Anytime it's faster than 500 milliseconds is a reasonable response time for something like this. And in contrast to a lot of continuous performance tasks, which this is, the timing between stimuli can be pretty long. So typically, the inner stimulus interval or inner trial interval for a task like this is just 100 milliseconds or 500 milliseconds. But here we might wait 1 to 10 seconds between them. And that's sort of what makes it different than a lot of simple response time tasks. Because you're not constantly making responses, then it gives you a chance to wait and to thus fall asleep or have sleep lapses. I think this task, we're not going to do the whole thing, but it continues for about 10 minutes. And it's just like this. And so, sort of by design, it's pretty boring. If it weren't boring, you wouldn't get people falling asleep during it. And we'll do one more and then look at some of the things that we can change in the settings. Okay, so that's the default settings, and it's modeled after basically the parameters in the Wilkinson version and probably the Dingus version. But there's a few different ways you can run the task, and these are available within the parameter settings. So if we enter here, we can see the parameter settings, and the default is type 3. It indicates a trial number limit. So it says you're going to do this many trials, I don't care how long it takes. And so trial number is 120. And so 120 for, let's see, the default time between trials makes it about a 10-minute task. But you could also do test type 1, which is a total time limit. So for type 1, you might say, I don't care how many trials I want to have, I want, say, 10 minutes. And so 600 would be 600 seconds in this case. So 600 seconds of testing would equal 10 minutes. Now, and so if you did type 1, it wouldn't care about how many trials, it would just care about how long. So this might be a more reasonable thing to do if you have a fixed amount of time, because remember, if someone's falling asleep, a single trial could take 5 minutes. And so maybe you just want to record 10 minutes and use whatever comes out of it as the dependent measure. There's also a block number limit, so you can specify the number of blocks. So here you might have 12 blocks, and I guess, actually, I'm not sure how the block number limit works. It's probably something like either a fixed time per block or a fixed number of trials per block. So we can look at that. So if we look for if we look for test type 2, has blocks of trials, and actually, I'm gonna have to figure out what it uses for how long each block of trials is. Okay, so those are three operation methods that you could have, and they're specified here. Now, on an individual trial level, we can specify how long we want the fixation on, and this is in milliseconds. So that cross at the beginning is 400 milliseconds. We could determine whether we want to give feedback. So you saw in this task, it told you how many milliseconds your response was. This seems pretty reasonable, but maybe you don't want that. So you can get rid of that here. This is mostly for analytics. You can specify the criteria for going too fast, and 150 milliseconds is a pretty good measure for going too fast. If people respond faster than that, they were probably just jamming the keyboard and got lucky or something like that. Or a sleep lapse, which in this case it's 500 milliseconds. This is maybe on the edge of what you want to consider a sleep lapse, but this seems to be standard within the community. And sleep attack. So you could recode all these responses yourself, but this just will mark in a column whether a response was too fast or a sleep lapse or something like that. Finally, although zero space bar is traditional, you might want to take advantage of sort of the much more sensitive mouse key to make the response. So if you say use mouse is equal to one, then it'll use the mouse instead of space bar. So set that to one. And we can run this again and see what happens because I hit the space bar, and now we'll see if we can really sort of respond by clicking the mouse button. And it's just the left mouse button is what accepts the key press. Do a couple more of these. Okay, that would have been a sleep lapse. Okay, so one more thing to look at is to see how long each trial takes. And the way it works is the time between trials is sampled from a, I saw it right here, set of values between 1 second and 10 seconds. And so by default, it will sample one of these values, and so the time between trials will be exactly this. Maybe you want to avoid people, maybe you kind of think people after 10 minutes of this will sort of guess and start counting and make guesses that it's going to happen either on every second or something. So you could use a continuous one as well. So that's what the use continuous is set to. So by default, use continuous will be one. And so, in fact, it won't set them between 1 to 10. But I think at least some of the original versions of the PVT use a sampling scheme like this. So that's why this was set as an option. So by default, it will sample between 1,000 and 10,000 milliseconds uniformly. But if you want these specific numbers, you can have that, which might give you a way of binning your responses across different delays to see if there's more sleep lapses as the delays get longer. Of course, you can, if you want to change the time between trials and maybe make a 10, a 20, a 30-second trial, you could add numbers to here. There would be no problem with just editing this file and adding numbers. So to edit the file, you can select the PVT.pbl and say edit open selected, and it will open it in your selected text editor. So that is the Pebble PVT. It's widely used, and this is just a basic overview of how to use it and how to change it to make it do exactly what you want. Thank you.